Hello, I am Sharon Beekmann, Chair of the EPC Women's Resource Council. The Council administers the EPC Women's Ministry called the WELL, Women's Resources. We exist to serve you, women in EPC churches, and we want to help you connect with the EPC women across our denomination and to provide resources for ministry in the local church. Please visit our website, blog, and Facebook group. The link to the blog and Facebook can be found on the EPC website. On the website, you'll also find vetted resources on discipleship, evangelism, healing, prayer, and leadership. We selected ones to help you grow in your love for Christ, to be bold in your faith, and to be equipped to serve Him. The resources are biblically based and theologically sound. In our video series, council members want to bless you as they share personal experiences and insights into their journey with Christ. I hope you'll stick with me for a few more minutes as I talk about discernment in a video I recorded earlier. Imagine walking down a path on a foggy day. Mist is around you and you hear laughter and strain to see who is ahead of you. Two blurry figures emerge from the cloud. Then you see two boys tossing a ball into the air for the other to catch. You smile. You know enough about fog and boys tossing a ball to move closer to the side of the road. Christian discernment is something like walking through fog. We strain to know what is of God and what is not. But we have this assurance. God walks with us on the road. He gives us everything we need to know and serve Him. God Himself is the source of discernment. He has given us His Word, the Holy Spirit, the body of Christ, the church, to grow in Him. God Himself gives us clarity. Discernment is separating truth from error, right from wrong. It pertains to how we digest what is presented to us. What do we take in? What do we spit out? Discernment is, first, a rational process. We use our intellect and minds to understand what God has revealed about Himself and His creation in Scripture. It's a skill that we can learn. We study Scripture and we seek His holiness by loving and obeying Him. Our goal is to see the world through God's eyes. We study and equip ourselves to discern and grapple with what is and is not of Him. Children of God want to please the Father. And discernment is closely aligned with wisdom. Proverbs 16:21 says, "The wise in heart are called discerning, and gracious words promote instructions." Now think about these examples. The woman who knew enough about boys tossing a ball that she moved to the other side of the road. When a friend first learns about a serious illness, a wise woman shows compassion. It's not the time to give her a lecture on preventative care. And when a friend betrays us, we understand that when all is said and done, God wants us to forgive them in our heart. When someone is hungry, we feed them. When it seems that evil has won the day, we understand that this earth is not our true home. We believe that Christ will come again in judgment, in all His glory, and we will reign with Him forever. How do we know these things? Because God reveals them in His Word. He tells us about Jesus, the author of our faith, and we read in Colossians 1:19-20, "For God was pleased to have all His fullness dwell in Him, and through Him to reconcile all things to Himself, whether things on earth or things in heaven, by making peace through His blood shed on the cross." And a few verses later, in 28 and 29, the Apostle Paul writes, "He is the one we proclaim, admonishing and teaching everyone with all wisdom, so that we may present everyone fully mature in Christ." And to this end, I strenuously contend with all the energy Christ so powerfully works in me. See, God Himself leads us to clarity. God Himself lifts the fog so we can see. I hope this discussion has been a blessing to you. For more information on the well, please see our website and blog and connect with us on social media. Thank you for watching, and may God richly bless you today.